Hello, my name is Sarah Ashley and I am a postdoc from the Murdoch Children's Research Institute. Today it is my pleasure to present to you research on behalf of my co-authors recently published in Allergy. Titled Allergen-Specific, IgE is a stronger predictor of remission following peanut oral immunotherapy than age in children aged 1 to 10 years. Oral immunotherapy, or OIT, is a promising intervention for food allergy. Although OIT is effective at inducing desensitization in the majority of treated patients, remission, defined as clinical non-reactivity following a period of allergen avoidance after treatment, is only achieved in a subset. Remission is a desired outcome as it allows individuals to discontinue treatment, reintroduce the allergen into the diet, and has been associated with significant improvements in health-related quality of life. Identification of accurate and reliable predictors of remission at baseline could aid patient selection, provide a valuable tool for shared clinical decision-making, and empower individuals to make informed choices about pursuing OIT. While allergen-specific IgE has been consistently linked to the attainment of remission, the evidence surrounding age as a predictor is conflicting. We examined the relationship between baseline peanut-specific IgE and age as predictors of remission following peanut oral immunotherapy in children aged 1 to 10 in data from PPOET 3. PPOET 3 was a phase 2b randomized control multicenter trial of probiotic and peanut oral immunotherapy versus peanut oral immunotherapy without the probiotic versus placebo. Patients were randomized 2 to 2 to 1, and the trial was completed in 2019. The study design is shown here, and we assessed the relationship between baseline factors and the attainment of remission in the two active arms. And treatment was a period of 18 months, and outcomes were assessed using two double-blind placebo-controlled food challenges, one directly following the final dose of treatment, assessing levels of desensitization, and one following a 2-month period of allergen avoidance to assess remission. Peanut SIG was a stronger predictor of remission than age. We can see that visualized here with the raw data, where those who attained remission are colored in gold and those without remission in white. And along the x-axis, we have the baseline log peanut SIGE levels. We can see that the higher the peanut SIGE was, the lower the odds of attaining remission. And on the y-axis is the baseline age. However, age alone did not separate the two outcome groups. And when we assess these two baseline variables in univariate and multivariate regression models, we found that higher peanut SIG at baseline was consistently associated with a lower likelihood of remission, independent of age. However, there was no independent association between age and remission after we adjusted for baseline SIG. Using receiver operator curve analysis, we found that peanut SIGE was strongly predictive of the remission outcome with an area under the curve of 0.89. Age, on the other hand, had a poor predictive capacity for remission, shown here on the right. In conclusion, contrary to popular belief that earlier initiation of OIT in younger children leads to higher rates of remission, our findings do not support age as an independent predictor of remission following OIT. The association between age and remission may be due to the fact that younger children tend to have lower levels of peanut SIGE. Importantly, these findings suggest that older children with lower levels of IgE can still gain benefit from treatment. Thank you.